and in the earth is yours. Yours is the kingdom, O Lord, and you are exalted as head above all. Blessed be the Lord our God. Blessed be Jesus Christ. Blessed be the Spirit of God. The Jubilate, or Psalm 100, found on page 37. Oh, shout to the Lord in triumph, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his face with songs of joy. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who has made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Come into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and bless his holy name, for the Lord is good. His loving mercy is forever, his faithfulness throughout all generations. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Our prayer of intention. Let us pray. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. Please kneel. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. The appointed Psalms for this morning are Psalms 148, 149, and 150. Beginning on page 664, Psalms 148, 149, and 150. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights. Praise him, sun and moon. Praise him, all you shining stars. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he commanded, and they were created. Praise the Lord from the earth, you sea monsters and all deeps. Mountains and all hills, fruit trees and all cedars. Kings of the earth and all peoples, princes and rulers of the world. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name only is exalted. His splendor is over earth and heaven. Hallelujah. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing his praise in the congregation of the faithful. Let them praise his name in the dance. Let them sing praise to him with timbrel and harp. Let the faithful rejoice in triumph. Let them be joyful on their beds. To wreak vengeance on the nations and punishment on the peoples. To inflict on them the judgment decreed. This is glory for all his faithful people. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God in his holy temple. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him with the blast of the ram's horn. Praise him with lyre and harp. Praise him with resounding cymbals. Praise him with loud clanging cymbals. Let every praise the Lord. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our first reading for this morning, please, taken from Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 1 and verses 4 through 14.
The first reading is taken from Jeremiah chapter 29, verses 1 and 4 to 14. Jeremiah chapter 29, verses 1 and then 4 to 14. These are the words of the letter that the prophet Jeremiah sent from Jerusalem to the remaining elders among the exiles, and to the priests, the prophets, and all the people whom Nebuchadnezzar had taken into exile from Jerusalem to Babylon. Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, to all the exiles whom I have sent into exile from Jerusalem to Babylon, build houses and live in them, plant gardens and eat what they produce. Take wives and have sons and daughters. Take wives for your sons and give your daughters in marriage, that they may bear sons and daughters. Multiply there and do not decrease, but seek the welfare of the city where I have sent you into exile, and pray to the Lord on its behalf. For in its welfare you will find your welfare. For thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, do not let the prophets and the diviners who are among you deceive you, and do not listen to the dreams that they dream. For it is a lie that they are prophesying to you in my name. I did not send them, says the Lord. For thus says the Lord, only when Babylon 70 years are completed will I visit you, and I will fulfill to you my promise and bring you back to the place, to this place. For surely I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord, plans for your welfare and not for harm, to give you a future with hope. Then will you call upon me and come and pray to me. I will hear you when you search for me, you will find me. If you seek me with all your heart, I will let you find me, says the Lord, and I will restore your fortunes and gather you from all the nations and all the places where I have driven you, says the Lord. And I will bring you back to this place from where I sent you into exile. This is the word of the Lord.
stand for the Benedictus found on page 40. Blessed are you, Lord, the God of Israel. You have come to your people and set them free. You have raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of your servant David. Through your holy prophets, you promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our forebears, and to remember your holy covenant. This was the oath you swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship you without fear, holy and righteous before you all the days of our life. A new child shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare the way, to give God's people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine upon those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Our second reading, please, taken from Acts chapter 16, verses 6 through 15.
The second lesson is taken from Acts chapter 16, verses 6 through 15. They went through the region of Phrygia and Galatia, having been forbidden by the Holy Spirit to speak the word in Asia. When they had come opposite Mysia, they attempted to go into Bithynia, but the Spirit of Jesus did not allow them. So passing by Mysia, they went down to Taurus. During the night, Paul had a vision. There stood a man of Macedonia, pleading with him and saying, "Come over to Macedonia and help us." When he had seen the vision, he immediately tried to cross over to Macedonia, being convinced that God had called us to proclaim the good news to them. We set sail from Taurus and took a straight course to Samothrace, the following day to Neapolis, and from there to Philippi, which is a leading city of the district of Macedonia and a Roman colony. We remained in this city for some days. On the Sabbath day, we went outside the gate by the river, where we supposed there was a place of prayer, and we sat down and spoke to the women who had gathered there. A certain woman named Lydia, a worshiper of God, was listening to us. She was from the city of Thyatira and a dealer in purple cloth. The Lord opened her heart to listen eagerly to what was said by Paul. When she and her household were baptized, she urged us, saying, "If you have judged me to be faithful to the Lord, come and stay at my home." And she prevailed upon us. The word of the Lord.
Please stand and turn with me to page 56, page 56, and together we would say, God's plan of salvation, page 56. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with all the spiritual blessings of heaven. God chose us in Christ before the world was made to be holy and blameless, and to live by his love in his presence. God planned through Jesus Christ to bring us to himself as his children, that we might praise the glory of his grace, his free gift to us in the beloved. In Christ we gain redemption. Through the blood our sins are forgiven. How rich is the grace of God. Let us affirm our faith as we together we say the Apostles' Creed, found on page 42. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please kneel. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The suffrages form B, found on page 44, form B. Show us your mercy, O Lord. Clothe your ministers with righteousness. Give peace, O Lord, in all the world. Lord, keep this nation under your care. Let your way be known upon earth. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten. Create in us clean hearts, O God. Using our bulletins for this morning, please turn to page 3 as together we say the collect for today. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, in Christ you have revealed your glory among the nations. Preserve the works of your mercy, that your church throughout the world may persevere with steadfast faith in the confession of your name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us together say the prayers, the third and fourth prayer found on page 45 of your prayer books. Page 4, 5. Third and fourth prayer. Let us pray together. Into your hands, Lord, we commend ourselves this day. Let your presence be with us to its close. Strengthen us to remember that in whatever good work we do, we are serving you. Give us a diligent and watchful spirit that we may seek in everything to know your will, and knowing it, may gladly perform it. To the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the rest of the past night and for the gift of a new day with its opportunities of pleasing you. Grant that we may surpass its hours in the perfect freedom of your service, that at evening we may again give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We continue on page 46 with the collect for Sundays. Let us pray. O God, you make us glad with the weekly remembrance of the glorious resurrection of your Son, our Lord. Give us this day such blessings through our worship of you, that the week to come may be spent in your favor through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We continue with our prayers. Found on page 79, page 79. Together, let us pray for our parish. Almighty and ever-living God, ruler of all things in heaven and earth, hear our prayers for this parish family. Strengthen the faithful, arouse the careless, and restore the penitent. Grant us all things necessary for our common life, and bring us all to be of one heart and mind within your holy church through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We continue on page 82. Page 82. Let us pray for our homes and families. Heavenly Father, whose Son Jesus Christ, born of a woman, sanctified childhood and shared the life of an earthly home, bless the homes and families of our nation. Give to parents a true sense of responsibility in the care and training of their children, that our boys and girls may grow up in the fear of your name and the fellowship of your church for the glory of Christ our Lord. Amen. Our prayer of dedication found on page 47. Page 47. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us evermore. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be God. May the souls of the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. My brothers and sisters in Christ, this concludes our morning prayer with a heart of gratitude to God for bringing us all here to this morning. Turn to your neighbor and wish them good morning.
Good morning, everyone. Today is the 21st Sunday after Pentecost. Our service continues on page 101. You have the Book of Common Prayer. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed Lord and Father, we have assembled in your name and in fellowship with one another. Enable us by your grace to offer the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to proclaim and respond to your holy word. Teach us to pray for your world and your church. Grant that we, confessing our sins, may worthily offer to you our souls and bodies as a living sacrifice and eat and drink of your spiritual food. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may through Christ our Lord.
Be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray, Almighty and everlasting God. In Christ you have revealed your glory among the nations. Preserve the work of your mercy, that your church throughout the world may persevere with steadfast faith in the confession of your name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Collect for the Diocese. Almighty Father, we thank people to be in communion with you and each other. Hear the prayers of the parishes and communities within this diocese that are faced with many challenges. By the power of your Holy Spirit, strengthen and inspire us to live lives pleasing to you. Help us to remain faithful as we use the gifts and talents you have given us for for the building up of your church and the communities it serves. For the sake of him who came among us as one who serves, your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus, chapter 33, verses 12 to 23. Moses said to the Lord, "See, you have said to me, 'Bring up this people,' but you have not let me know whom you will send with me. You have said, 'I know you by name,' and you have also found favor in my sight. Now, if I have found favor in your sight, show me your ways so that I may know you and find favor in you. Consider too that this nation is your people." He said, "My presence will go with you, and I will give you rest." And he said to him, "If your presence will not go, do not carry us from here. For how shall it be known that I have found favor in your sight, I and your people, unless you go with us? In this way, we shall be distinct, I and your people, from every people on the face of the earth." The Lord said to Moses, "I will do everything that you have asked, for you have found favor in my sight, and I know you by name." Moses said, "Show me your glory, I pray." And he said, "I will make all my goodness pass before you, and will proclaim before your name, the Lord, and I will be gracious to whom I will be gracious, and will show mercy on whom I will show mercy." But he said, "You cannot see my face, for no one shall see me and live." And the Lord continued, "See, there is a place by me where you shall stand on the rock. And while my glory passes by, I will put you in a cleft of the rock. I will cover you with my hand until I have passed by. Then I will take away my hand, and you will see my back, but my face shall not be seen." The word of the Lord.
Thank you. a reading from the first letter of Paul to the Thessalonians, chapter 1, verses 1 to 10. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy to the church of the Thessalonians in God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace to you and peace. We always give thanks to God for all of you and mention you in our prayers, constantly remembering before our God and Father your work of faith and labor of love and steadfastness of hope in our Lord Jesus Christ. For we know, brothers and sisters, beloved by God, that he has chosen you, because our message of the gospel came to you, not in word only, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit, and with full conviction, just as you know what kind of persons we proved to be among you for your sake. And you become imitators of us and of the Lord. For in spite of persecution, you receive the word with joy, inspired by the Holy Spirit, so that you become an example of all the believers in Macedonia and in Asia. For the word of the Lord has sounded forth from you, not only in Macedonia and Asia, but in every place. Your faith in God has become known, so that we have no need to speak about it. For the people of those regions report about us what kind of welcome we had among you, and how you turned to God from idols to serve a living and true God, and to wait for his Son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead, Jesus, who rescue us from the wrath that is coming. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lord be with you.
And also with you.
I read the Holy Gospel according to Matthew chapter 22, beginning at the 15th verse. The Pharisees went and plotted to entrap Jesus in what he said. So they sent their disciples to him, along with their audience, saying, Teacher, we know that you are sincere and teach the way of God in accordance with truth and show deference to no one, for you do not regard people with partiality. Tell us then, what do you think? Is it lawful to pay taxes to the emperor or not? But Jesus, aware of their malice, said, Why are you putting me to the test, you hypocrites? Show me the coin used for the tax. And they brought him a denarius. Then he said to them, Whose head is this? And whose title? They answered the emperor. Then he said to them, Give therefore to the emperor the things that are the emperor's, and to God the things that are God's. When they heard this, they were amazed, and they left him and went away. This is the gospel of Christ. I speak in his name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Some words from the gospel for today. This little short snippet from Matthew's gospel, chapter 22, verse 15 to 22. The Pharisees went and plotted to entrap Jesus in what he said. So they sent their disciples to him, along with the Herodians, saying, "Teacher, we know that you are sincere and teach the way of God in accordance with truth and show deference to no one, for you do not regard people with partiality." Lotion, my dear friends. Jesus was being lotioned and he could feel in his spirit that it was not sincere. He knew deep down that the persons who were coming to him had a desire to plot and entrap him by what he said. Has anyone ever been in a predicament or been placed in a situation where a question was put to you, where if you answered one way, you'd be in trouble, or you answered the next way, you'd be in trouble? A loaded question is what we call it, a double-edged sword. Here are a couple of examples of loaded questions. Are you still cheating at dominoes? If you answer yes, you're admitting that you cheat. And if you answer no, you're admitting that you was cheating in the first place. I usually ask parents, which one of your children or which one of your children is a favorite? They would never answer because they say, "Father, I love all the same." You're either going to admit one is favorite or you got to admit one is not favorite. And so they say, "Father, I love all the same." Sometimes, my dear friends, a loaded question is asked to try and trick a person into saying something that they don't want to. Jesus, my dear friends, was placed in this predicament. Jesus was gaining great momentum, great popularity among the Israelites. And this was very upsetting to the Pharisees and their audience. They thought that he was a threat to their authority. And they tried everything they could do to entrap Jesus and make him look bad. Jesus had more followers day by day. And so a group of Pharisees met and plotted together to entrap Jesus by this question. The people in Jesus' day required to pay taxes to the Roman government. That was not popular with the people, as it's not popular with us. The plan was to go to Jesus and ask about paying taxes. So they sent the disciples as a ploy with a few Herodians and their followers. And Jesus knew that they were not honest. He knew that they were crooked. And so the way that Jesus deals with the question, my dear friends, is actually trying to trick them. Jesus asks, my dear friends, for a coin. And he says, "Whose face or inscription is on this coin?" And they say, "Caesar." Caesar was a Roman ruler, and all taxes had to be paid to him. Jesus then said to them, "Give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and give to God what belongs to God." The printing in front of your bulletin. But what about God, my dear friends? Jesus said, "Give to God what belongs to God." The Bible says we are created in God's image. We are image people of God. If we are created in God's image, we are created to do his will, to sing his praises. And as this choir has sung, we want Jesus to walk with us. The Pharisees wanted him to say something like, "God is more important than the emperor. Religion is more important than the emperor." They wanted him to put these two spheres of authority in competition with each other. But Jesus, God, and the emperor was quite different. We can give the governments of this day and the governments of past years all credit because you know what? They all served in various capacities. The Herodians were Jews who supported the king, Herod's dynasty, and therefore tolerated their Roman overlords better than any common people would. Although they were on the opposite side of the law, my dear friends, they all joined forces to pay Emperor Caesar his tithes and his offerings. The choice of question, my dear friends, of paying taxes to Caesar is what Jesus was trying to get at. Jesus answered he would not alienate himself from either the Jewish listeners who hated the tax, and he would not support them who know that he was not a supporter of the tax. While the question was quite clever, Jesus recognized their wickedness an hypocrisy in asking it. He knew they were looking for the truth and they were merely seeking a mere opportunity to destroy him. The word render means to give back, implying that the believers who are responsible to respect and obey authority are well deserved and chosen by God. All governments are in the power and authority of God and should be obeyed unless the edicts contradict the word of God. Jesus' comparison of the responsibilities of God and the responsibility of government centers around the center of the power and the struggle, my dear friends, that the persons endured during that time. With his proclamation, Jesus acknowledges God's law, what is printed on our currency. What is given today, my dear friends, is various denominations of money. We are created in God's image, and Jesus calls us to return to God, and we are called all to give ourselves back to God. We can give the government what we owe in taxes, my dear friends, but what extent do we owe to God who has given us so much? On the other hand, my dear friends, there's no limit to what God has done for us. Every night we lay down, every morning we get up, every morning we put on our clothes and put on our shoes, and God has done so much for us. The problem is, my dear friends, that we don't live as people of God sometimes. We make giving to the government a task. The customs department, my dear friends, bragged about how much they gained from this new click and pay, as each person is required to enter a custom sheet as they enter the country returning from the States. My dear friends, customs has hit a jackpot here. And my dear friends, we are asking ourselves, were Bahamians that bad when they came back from the United States to say, oh, I didn't spend any money, only spent $200. But despite what happens, my dear friends, the customs department say they have gained so much. Jesus, my dear friends, reminds us that when we give to him, we give so much back to ourselves. Our first loyalty is to God. We do not give taxes, we pay for them. We do not give taxes, my dear friends, we pay for them. How does knowing what belongs to God determine our response to the government? And a government does not understand how much we owe to God. God is almost more into us than anything else. God is more into us than we are into ourselves. Our loyalty to the government should be limited and relative, but our loyalty to God should be limitless. God is our sacred head, the one who gives us so much. The only one kingdom, my dear friends, we'll all live and die for is when we go to heaven. The government has stamped images on the currency of this day. So Lyndon Penland is on the dollar stamp, on the dollar bill. A.D. Hanna is on the $100 bill, and the list goes on. But we must obey our government in earthly realms. The things that are God do not belong to the government, and the things that are government do not belong to God. Human governments are legitimate according to God's good purpose. If they need taxes to be fulfilled to their calling, we pay VAT, we pay other taxes, and we pay taxes in accordance with what we buy in the stores. The coin, my dear friends, which Jesus was referring to, bears the image of the emperor. It was only the value that was placed on it that made it important. Those who bear the image of God, my dear friends, even those who are being beaten down and robbed of their dignity, possess value and inherent to God's law because we are God's people and God's children whom he's created in his image. One day, my dear friends, all kingdoms and empires of this world will fall. And the only currency that will last, my dear friends, will be God and God alone. God will still be God, and we will still be his children. My dear friends, Father Roderick Green likes to say in his sermon says, we all and Bahamians, he can die. And when I die, I want to wake and behold God's face with a smile and not a frown. Most of us do not want to pay taxes, but we want to have money in the bank for other purposes. We want smooth roads, no potholes, and enjoy many other amenities. But my dear friends, the benefit does not recur if we don't pay taxes. My dear friends, it makes a difference, my dear friends, if we pay taxes to the government and they're not enabled or in a position to repair the roads. But my dear friends, we need to speak up if we see wrongness being done. In Russia, my dear friends, there's no citizen crying out that Putin should stop invading Ukraine. Isn't that something? Putin has been on a tear, on a rampage from last year, and no one in the government, people can say, let's stop this war. Let's give the people back their land. The same, my dear friends, happened about 2 weeks ago in Israel. The Hamas, my dear friends, bombarded Israel. And now the war continues back and forth. Anyone is speaking up? Only President Biden, my dear friends, has the guts and intestinal fortitude to travel to the land and say, let's work for peace. We cannot separate, my dear friends, ourselves from this world that we live in. But all we can do is pray for peace in the Middle East. Pray for peace between Russia and Ukraine. Paul wrote, my dear friends, God lives in us as we live in him. We may feel that we have not chosen the right path, my dear friends, but look around it. Look around you, my dear friends. The world and your week is more better when we start here in church. We live in a society of good people, but most good people talk about God, they preach about him, but ask them where they spend their Sunday mornings. You know what is so funny, my dear friends? Our bed feels more sweeter on Sunday morning than any other morning. But as I demand, my dear friends, that we get up and go to church and worship this God whom we serve. By calling attention, my dear friends, to these alarming situations, Jesus reminds us that the difference exists between citizens and state and citizens of heaven. Jesus clearly suggests that we ought to state exactly what is demanded of us, but by contrasting it with a statement to give God what is God, Jesus exposed the irony of the Pharisees and the Herodians. Religious people, my dear friends, put us in a box. We need to think outside of the box and say, God, give myself away, and you can use me. Despite the differences then and now, we are still in a world where there are different entities, constantly making complete demands of us. We have to pay this tax, we have to pay that tax. And my dear friends, as a U.S. commercial, you only pay what you get for. You only pay what you get. What is it? You only pay what you get, or you only pay what you want. My dear friends, me and Chelsea traveled to Eleuthera last week to attend a grand uncle's funeral. We paid for this particular airline. And instead of this airline saying that we are not flying our plane this time, we have the charter flight going, they put us on a five-seater. Now, my knees buckle in as I go towards the flight because I say to myself, yeah, but people, you know what? And as we walk to the flight, I say, Chelsea can't see me shaking and all that. But you know what? It demands of us that what we pay for, we must get. If I pay for a particular flight, I must get a particular flight. And if it's not that, I'm not going at all. How many of us, my dear friends, get hoodwinked, bamboozled, taken advantage of because what we paid for is not what we got? My dear friends, do we ask ourselves, are we using our time, our talents, and our treasures to the honor and glory of God? My dear friends, I was in a particular place at a particular time yesterday afternoon, and it seemed that the energy and the synergy was all complete. There was talking, there was laughing, and there was fellowship. One of my principals once said, and I still remember to today, there can't be fellowship if all the fellas ain't on the ship. There can't be fellowship if all the fellas ain't on the ship. And so as we fellowship together, my dear friends, in this environment, the ushers take it to the realm where when their arms are open, when their smile comes and greets the persons coming in, something's uploaded at the door, and they're looking forward to the service that is going to take place in a few minutes. Do we stop, my dear friends, in this world that we live in, and say to the elderly person or to the handicapped person in the food store, I'll pay for your goods? Yesterday it happened to me. I was in the DQ getting some ice cream, and Miss Johnson, Patrick Johnson's widow, came and said, Father, you can pay for my own. I can even stammer, but I said, yes, I'm going to pay for it. Because it demands that when we talk about this Christian love, somebody in the back of us has not the sufficient change to pay for the good, so I'm going to pay for it. What do you say, Cracker? We are all in this together. Two, do we approach Father and volunteer to be in an organization or to demand some energies placed on a particular organization where we will head? Not pointing the finger. Because when you point the finger, three fingers point back at us. What am I going to do? And so today, my dear friends, do we ignore warning signs of abuse to people in our community? Many people are hurting, my dear friends. And just that hug, just an encouraging word would make a difference. We, my dear friends, are the church. How we live our lives outside of the church is the only way some people will see God. We need to do it. Do we show our community meetings, show about community meetings and say, and protest when something wrong is being done? A few weeks ago, or maybe a week ago, they said that Paradise Island, I know some people work for Atlantis, and they said that Atlantis wanted to have a plane land in the area of Montague. And persons protest because they said that's a livelihood. That's a beach area. And so the same way they stepped forward and said, this is not right and this is wrong, place it somewhere else. We need to do it when wrong is being done. My dear friends, we as community need to stand up and get the intestinal fortitude to say, when wrong is being done, we as Anglicans, we as a church people should say, it is wrong. How does the way we use our resources reflect the truth? We're looking for resources, my dear friends. We're looking for natural resources. Are we living in a world that we are seeing so many people hurting, seeing so many people hiding and harmed? And we just go on as if it's another day. The place of worship, my dear friends, the door should be wide open, as they are now. Welcoming the poor, the marginalized, the least of the prophets, the least of the people, the least of those who consider in the kingdom of God. Do we seek to take advantage of people and use people and not things? Influence, my dear friends, gets us to where we are. If you want to be muck-a-muck, my dear friends, let God do it for you. Don't take advantage of people. And don't seek to destroy them when you go out in your daily lives. Jesus is not talking about us, my dear friends. He's talking about our loyalty to the government and our loyalty to God. He's suggesting that loyalty tends and befriends, accompanied by hope. Our loyalty to things, my dear friends, can take very many chances. We are loyal to authoritative figures. We're loyal to our teachers. We're loyal to our priests, our politicians. But my dear friends, are we loyal to our parents, our own brothers and sisters whom we see and interact with every day? Jesus not only models the life of giving everything to God, but he also makes it possible for us to do the same. Because he has trusted God and he came to us, emptied himself and humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on the cross. He has offered us new life. And in his dwelling, my dear friends, we have new life because we believe in him. Like Jesus, we can trust in God, love and care. Freely give to God ourselves, our time, our talents and our treasures. Should we hold up on any gift that God has given us? If we are sincere, my dear friends, all to Jesus I surrender. All to him I freely give. If we are sincere in our desire in the church, as church disciples, our answer should be to the question, whose image is this? It should be Jesus' image engraved in our hearts. His image is carved in our mold, our minds and our souls. And every breath we take, we should say, Lord, have mercy. We give so much when we give it to God. And God does so much when we give it back to him. Jesus calls for us to be engaged with everyone around us, to truly interact and become involved in the lives of people. The beams of the cross, my dear friends, intersect one vertical and one horizontal. God and Jesus, and Jesus and man. St. Augustine of Hippo once said these words, the Son of God became Son of Man so the sons of men can become sons of God. We will be voluntary, my dear friends, in all our giving. But you know what? When God calls us home, my dear friends, we must answer yes. We have done his will. Or no, our friends, our relatives have been in church, but we didn't find time to go there. But you know what? He will all say to us like Janet Jackson, what have you done for me lately? I know some people say, my daddy was singing in the choir, or my daddy serving all. What have you done for me lately? We are demanded of God to use our resources. And as the front of the bulletin reminds us, yes, give to the government what belongs to the government. And the things that are the government, give to them. But oh, hallelujah, all to Jesus. We surrender. All to him we freely give. In his name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you.
Intercession is found on page 112 form E. Let us pray for the fellowship of the Church of Christ and for all God's creation. With all who confess the name of Jesus as Lord and Savior, we offer our prayers and praises in spirit and in truth. Father in heaven,
hear our prayer.
With Jesus Christ, our great high priest, who ever lives to intercede for us, we uphold all ministers of God's word and sacraments that they may fulfill their high calling in the faith. Father in heaven,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the unfailing guidance of the Holy Spirit on those who are called to interpret it and expound the will of the Lord to others. Father in heaven,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all organizations within the fellowship of the body of Christ, that their work may edify the people of God and bear faithful witness to the gospel. Father in heaven,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all persons who do not share our confessions of faith, that with courage, truth, and love, we may work together with them and promote the common good. Father in heaven,
hear our prayer.
For the leaders of our country and all who make decisions on our behalf, that they may be guided by the Spirit to direct our affairs in righteousness and peace. Father in heaven,
hear our prayer.
For our judges, magistrates, and all who administer justice, that in all things they may seek to do your will and to protect the rights and freedom of your people. Father in heaven,
hear our prayer.
In our schools and in all other places of learning, may true knowledge, sound wisdom, and godly discipline ever be found. Father in heaven,
hear our prayer.
To the poor, the hungry, the unemployed, and all victims of persecution and discriminations of any kind, may God in Christ help us all to be relief, to bring relief, justice, and protection. Father in heaven,
hear our prayer.
To all who suffer now from pain and disease, from human discomfort and misery, may God in Christ bring healing and joy for the renewal of their faith. Father in heaven,
hear our prayer.
That we may use aright the fullness of the earth, that our pursuits in science and the advancements of our skills may ever be in service of that truth humanity, which is created in the image of God. Father in heaven,
hear our prayer.
That we may never become the slaves of money or of the lust for power, but may rather strive for victory through the power of love. Father in heaven,
hear our prayer.
That with all who belongs to the communion of saints, both living and departed, we may ever rejoice in the blessed assurance of that hope, which has been won for us in Christ. Father in heaven,
receive these. The act of penitence. If we say we have no sin, we have deceived ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, he will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us therefore confess our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and one another in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone. We are sorry and repent of all our sins. For your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to glory of your name. May the Almighty God have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please stand. We are the body of Christ. By the one Spirit we are all baptized into one body, and have all been made to drink of the one Spirit.
Let us then salute the name
and drink for peace. My friends in Christ, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace. Father, we offer you these gifts that you have given us, this bread, this wine, this money. With them, we offer ourselves, our lives, and our work to become, through your Holy Spirit, a reasonable, holy, and lively sacrifice. As this bread and wine become the body and blood of Christ, so may we and all your people become channels of your love through the same Christ. Amen.
be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to
give God thanks and
praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father Almighty, everlasting God, because on this most glorious day a triple light was given. On the first day of creation, you brought light and life into being. On the first day for our salvation, you raised your Son victorious over death. And on this day you give your holy and life-giving Spirit to your church. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
On page 142. Sovereign Lord and Father, to you be glory and praise forever. In your boundless wisdom, you brought creation into being. In your great love, you fashioned us in your image. In your tender compassion, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior, to share our human nature. In the power of the Holy Spirit, he overcame the power of sin and death and brought your people to new birth as first fruits of your new creation. On the night that he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this and eat it. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And after supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, according to the command of your dearly beloved Son, remember, we proclaim. And we offer you, Father, our sacrifice of thanks and praise. Send your Holy Spirit on these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, Jesus, our Lord and Redeemer. As we partake of this holy food of new and unending life, may your Holy Spirit establish us as a royal priesthood, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. John the Baptist, St. Joseph, St. Barnabas, and all your sons and daughters who share in your eternal inheritance through Jesus Christ our Lord. With him and in him and through him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father Almighty, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honor and glory be yours.
Amen. As our Savior has taught us, so we pray. Forgive us our sins, we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because
the gifts of God for the people of God. Be with you. Let us pray the post-communion prayer, second post-communion prayer. Eternal God and Heavenly Father, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you and all persons in you with gladness and singleness of heart through your Son. Amen.
May God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you now and always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Good morning, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Today is the 21st Sunday after Pentecost. If you are visiting with us this morning, would you kindly stand at this time? My visitors don't want to stand. We have Randy Lundy and Chrissy Hanna visiting with us. Would you kindly stand? They're from Evangelistic Center. Please stand. And Charles Johnson. I think he left early, yes. Charles was from Our Lady's Church. We hope you enjoyed our service, and please feel free to come back at any time. Please let us continue to pray for those who have lost loved ones, especially the family of Mrs. Hill and Mrs. Ferguson, who both were laid to rest this past week. And Dolores Williams and her family, who will lay to rest her brother, Jerome Francis, this coming week at First Baptist Church. Remember to pray for our sick and shut-in members and those that are in hospital. And show some love this week by just giving one of them a call, okay? The auxiliary general meeting will be held this coming Thursday at 6 p.m. All members are urged to attend, and please be on time. October is Youth Month. Please join our youth next Sunday for All Saints Costume Parade at the 10 a.m. service. Please be dressed in your favorite biblical character. There will be prizes for the best design. Remembrance Day is coming up, November the 12th. Our poppies are here. One single poppy is $1. And if you could get a poppy and a hand bracelet for $2. So please, let's support our Remembrance Day by purchasing a poppy or a poppy with a bracelet. The Usher Boys annual bingo night is set for November the 3rd. Please support and try your hand to win a 32-inch TV or a laptop. That's November the 3rd, right here at St. Barnabas Parish Hall. Wishing all of those celebrating birthdays this upcoming week a very happy birthday. And I would like to say especially happy birthday to Ms. Sylvia O'Brien, who's with us today, who's celebrating 85 years. and wishing all of you who are celebrating marital bliss. And we have Ms. Smith this morning. Mr. Harrell and Mrs. Smith are celebrating 28 years. Ms. Smith, please stand. No, your husband is not here, but stand. Thank you. May you live to see many, many, many more years. Now we have 2 minutes for mission this morning. Minutes for mission this morning. First, we have Ms. Sharika Burrows, who will come and talk about the Family Life Marriage Ministry. And following Sharika will be the drama club representing the old school dance, which will be held next week, Friday. I encourage you to play it this week, Friday, yes. Please, for the sake of time, take your bulletins home with you so you'll be updated on all that's happening at the church and the diocese. Now, there will be no evensong this evening, but please, we are all encouraged to come out and share with the Casilio Ministry Altrea. That's tonight at 6 p.m. Please join them tonight at 6 p.m. right here at the parish.
I will be 30 seconds. Happy Sunday. Good morning. I come to you this morning on behalf of the Diocesan Marriage Ministry. As we continue to build and mend marriages within the diocese, we want to end the year on a bang. So we're going to cuddle up and read. We are asking all married couples, engaged couples, to join us as we read the book Cherish by Gary Thomas. And we will read for the whole month of November. And during the month of November, we will have 2 Zoom meetings where we get together and we discuss what we have learned and what we will carry away from the reading. And then in December, we will end with a social. Okay? So if you are interested in reading with us, reading with your partner, please sign up. Send your message on marriageministry2023@gmail.com, or you can see me personally to get the information. Okay? So let's get ready to cuddle up and read. The cold weather is coming.
Presenting Brown Sugar Babe. We need our music. Here comes Miss Ginger. And we're not going to leave out our Dolomite. This morning, present some of our models for our showcase brought to you by the Old School Dance Committee. We want to give you some idea of how you can dress or not, but once you grace us with your presence. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about those 70s, 80s, and 90s clubs. We're talking about the banana boat, the cat and the fiddles, the Bahamian club, silver slippers, the jump beat, and Zanzibar, and many. I know y'all know a lot more than I do. Ooh, the time back then was so and it was out of sight. Can you dig it? Hey, sexy mama, jive turkey catch you on the flip side. The slang and the hustle was real, real. The tones, the times where there were real good food, real cool drinks, and the clothing was super fly. Mini skirts, raffle shirts, fur, bell bottoms, platforms, and of course, afro. Y'all remember the love, the peace, and the power to the people. Well, we're gonna bring it back, that old feeling back for one night. St. Barnabas Parish ACM and Yeshua Drama Ministry presents Disco Fever, an old school style dance celebrating the 60s, 70s, and 80s. It's gonna be this Friday, October 27, 2023 at St. John's College Auditorium. Tickets are priced at $20 with a complimentary fruit punch. Happy hour commences at 8 p.m. with Ace and DJ Gary. There will be door prizes and surprises. We're gonna even have contests with the best dress, male and female contest, best hairdo, best old school dancer. Food and drinks will be on sale. So come and let us groove the night away. Now this event is to raise funds for the ACM scholarship and for production supplies for drama ministry and of course, donation to our parish. So come and be a part of this event. And we're gonna have tickets on sale and on the porch. So see Royce, myself, or any other committee member for tickets, and those of you who are holding tickets and owe us money. Thank you.
CPWI 386, sing praises to God who reigns above. Good morning.
It's good to get the church back from the pimps and other people. But make sure you are a part of the old school dance on Friday at St. John's College. Take your wife and you more senior people, I don't want to call you old people, but the way you dressed back then was indeed fantastic. It seems very groovy. So go back and enjoy yourself, and may God bless you in your celebrations. I do also want to pray for the Wilsons. I saw them in the bulletin. They're celebrating 51 years of marital bliss. I know sometime they're watching, and there are others who are watching the live stream. But congratulations and happy anniversary to all those who celebrate, in particular Sir Franklin Wilson and Sharon Wilson at this time. And to all who are celebrating birthday, anniversary. All right, let us pray. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, amen. Bless now, O Lord Christ Jesus, we pray these your children. They come to say thank you for another year. Thank you for another milestone. These are your children. You created them in your image, in your likeness. And we know, Lord, that you are doing great things in their lives. As they increase in years now, increasing them your wisdom, your knowledge, your understanding. Cause them to grow closer and closer to you as each day go by. Bless them in a special way that they be a blessing to everyone that they meet on this life's journey. And let them know, Lord Christ Jesus, that you are with them, that greater is he that is in them than he that is in this world. Place them now, Lord Christ Jesus, where you would have them to go. That as they work in this life and as they continue on, you may fill them with your love, with your peace, with your joy, with your kindness, all those gifts that you promised to your faithful ones. Be with them now and always, Lord Christ Jesus. Protect them from all evil. We pray that no weapon, no darkness, no evil form against them prosper, but that they may be protected by you. Help them always to be good exemplars for you in this world, that people may see you in them and give you the glory. And now bless them, O Lord Christ, on this their birthday in a special way. Let them, O Lord Christ Jesus, continue on that one day they may see you face to face in your heavenly kingdom, where they may give you greater thanks and praise. And now may your blessing, that of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you now and always. Amen. Happy birthday and God bless you. All right. And to Phyllis, she stands here. Her husband is not well, but she stands nonetheless, and we pray for this marriage. Bless, O Lord, this marriage, we pray. Bless this man and this woman who stands here for her husband. We pray now that you will continue to bless them and keep them together till death do them part. You, O Lord, have brought them together out of all persons in this world, and we know that you are doing great things in their lives. Continue to minister to them joint and severally. Surround them with your love. Let them love you above all, but may they continue to love each other more and more as each day go by. As you continue with them now, Lord Christ Jesus, bless their home, their family, their children, their children's children, and be with them all their days, that they may live in joy and peace and harmony. We pray your healing hands upon your servant, Mr. Smith. Keep him, Lord Christ Jesus, in your care, and help this, your child, to minister to him in his illness, as they promise in sickness and in health. And we ask now, Lord Christ Jesus, that you will continue your blessing upon them, that blessing of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you, Phyllis, and do well. All right. Give our regards to your husband. Also on Thursday of this week, the police, Royal Bahamas Police Force, they have partnered with us, and they are giving a seminar of sorts on human trafficking. It's in the bulletin, so if you can attend, please do attend. It's a neighborhood event, but nonetheless, the church is a part of the neighborhood. And so it is hoped that we can come out and hear what is going on. There's lots of sex trafficking, there are lots of people trafficking, there are lots of different trafficking as it relates to people. And so they want to give us some heads up on all of this. So please, on Thursday of this week, all right? Thank you. We had Synod, it was successful. We will let you know of the proceedings shortly and the resolutions that came out of Synod. We continue to pray for a diocese. We continue to pray for world peace. And I do ask you also to pray for Mr. Knowles, Sir Knowles' brother, Charles. Charles Knowles is gravely ill. And we pray for him at this time. God bless you then, and see you tonight. Blessings. Our closing hymn.